Well,
then you were lying.
I was.
Now, where am I? This is Edmonton.
Right? We're in Edmonton.
I love Edmonton. You Edmontonians are the greatest. You really are.
Well, Edmonton is very happy to have you here, Stan.
And I'm very happy to be had. So what are we going to do now?
Well, we're going to take some questions. We've got some microphones set up over here and over here. Is that right? So don't be shy. Come on down and queue up for some questions. But I also wanted to talk a little bit about in Calgary, when I moderated your panel there, one of the funniest things you said, what I remembered, was Stan was relating a story, and he said, so, I'm doing you right now, okay, so I thought to myself, my wife always tells me, why do you keep saying you think to yourself? Who else are you thinking to?
I'm going to tell my wife that you remembered that. My wife is always correcting me. It's natural to say, gee, I thought to myself, what do you mean you thought to yourself? Who else would you think to? And she gets mad if I use any words that don't belong in it. She's the one who made me do the writing I do. Because if I didn't write as magnificently as I do, she'd yell at me.
That's what wives are for, right? Okay, we're going to start with a question over here.
Who's your favorite Marvel character and who's your favorite DC character?
Oh.
You have to forgive me. I know I look like a man who is perfect in every way, but I don't hear as well as I used to, so it's hard for me to make out the questions, so my friend Gary is going to repeat them. And I don't want you to think it's only because he likes to talk a lot, but anyway, who is my favorite character? Marvel and Dean. My favorite Marvel character is Spider-Man! My favorite DC character, I haven't come up with one yet.
Oh my.
Thank you. All right, we're going to go over to this side. Question?
Hi, sorry, I'm trying not to take up a lot of time, but thank you, Stanley. You were amazing. You're my idol, and that's part of my question, actually. You've changed so much in my life, and everyone here I know is here because of, so send me money. I do, every month, when the comics come out. And I just want to know, how does it feel to know that you and Mr. Kirby changed the world as we know it?
Well, I'm not sure that we changed the world. I hope that we gave some people a lot of reading enjoyment. That's about all that I can ask for or hope for. And the world, I think, sort of runs along the way it does, regardless of anything I can do about it. You're supposed to say, oh no, if not for you, everything would be different.
It really is, and you've changed everything everywhere. All these people all around the world are here because of what you've done and what you've invented. And thank you.
I like that man. Get his name, I like him.
We'll get his name. Thank you, sir. Let's go over here.
Thank you so much for being here today. Your cameo appearances are legendary. And I was wondering if you could appear in any non-Marvel film in a cameo, which would it be and why?
Well, maybe I am going to try to be in Star Wars. See how that works out.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you for the question. I was told I must always act humble.
Okay, this side, please.
Sticking with cameos, what's been your favorite cameo?
Oh, gosh, I like them all. I don't miss the new Star Wars. Not Star Wars. The new, which is one? X-Men. The next X-Men movie when it comes out. Because I have a cameo in that one. And I have a guest star with me in that cameo. I'm not going to tell you who it is, but you get a kick out of it. Star Wars, not Star Wars, X-Men, don't miss it.
Thank you.
Stan, if you forget, I'm wearing an X-Men shirt.
I wouldn't have spoken to you otherwise.
I walk up to Stan. When I was in Calgary moderating his panel, I had long hair. I said, Stan, we've got to take a new picture because I have shorter hair. He said, I don't take pictures with short hair, guys. Okay, we'll go over here.
Hi, amazing to have you here. I'm glad you're able to come back to Alberta. My first is, well, you took my first question. But my backup question was, what's been your favorite movie or TV adaptation of a comic book?
Gosh, I think most of the ones that Marvel has done. But before I answer that, do you see something hovering around and floating in the air?
Yeah, what is that? Steady camera.
Amazing. Think of that. No, I thought it was a drone. What was it, a drone?
A drone?
Yeah. Yeah, I thought it was a drone.
It's a DC drone, actually.
Anyway, what was the question? What's my favorite? What?
Your favorite adaptation.
Oh. Well, again, I thought the first Spider-Man really captured it so perfectly. And the first Iron Man was magnificent. Pretty good.
Awesome, thank you.
Two for the price of one. Okay, over here.
Just when you started out, did you think that the franchise would have this much like impact on the world, and you think it would become what it has become today?
No. You see, this is why I'm such a great interviewer, and people like to interview me, because I give these answers that they can really think about. No. No, actually, when I started out, people hated comic books. Most parents didn't want their kids to read comics. They thought that they're harmful, or they'll get the kids out of the habit of reading because they'll just be looking at the pictures all the time and they won't read a real book. I changed my name. I had a real name, like Stanley Martin Lieber, a real name. I changed it to Stan Lee because I didn't want to be known as the guy writing those comics. That's how much people hated them in those days. What happened since, I can't remember, but thank goodness they don't hate him now.
Thank you. Over here.
Okay, it doesn't sound like you like DC too much, but if you had to do a Spider-Man-Batman crossover, how would the synopsis go? Like, what villains would they face, and how would you write it?
Couldn't answer that until I sit down to write it. But let me tell you something, I don't really hate DC. A lot of the DC people are my very good friends. And they have some great artists and great writers and they do some great things. But it's more fun to pretend you're having a feud. People enjoy that. I used to meet with a guy who was the editor of DC. Years ago when I worked in New York, and every week, at least once a week, there was a little bar called Friar Tuck. I'd meet him for a drink, he'd drink some of the DC people, I'd drink some of the Marvel people. We had drinks together, we kidded around, we were friends. But it's more fun, as I say, for the public, if we act as if we hate each other. I will tell you something, though, to show why Marvel is so superior to DC. Years ago, we were called Atlas Comics. When we started the Fantastic Four and Spider-Man, I realized we were onto something new, and I thought we needed a new name. I didn't like Atlas too much, so I said, I thought and thought, and I said, let's call ourselves Marvel, because I love advertising, and in ads you can have things like, make mine Marvel. Welcome to the Marvel age of comics. I mean, there's so much you can do with a word like Marvel. So we did that. We changed our name to Marvel. Now, DC was called National Comics. When we changed our name to Marvel, some genius over there said, oh, we ought to change our name too. So they thought and they thought, and what did they come up with? We were Marvel, and they came up with DC. I mean, how dull a name could you think of? National Comics would have been better. They should have kept their old name. So you're either a Marvel fan or a DC fan. But don't get me wrong, we're all friends.
Well, the abbreviation DC could be Dull Comics in a way, right?
Brilliant, I never thought of that. I'll say that at the next panel I'm on. And I won't even quote you, I'll say I made it up. I do that.
I expect no less. Okay, we're going to get a question on this side, please.
I really like your work and stuff, but I wonder, where did the Excelsior quote come from?
Excelsior came from it. We have to get back to DC again. I was using a lot of phrases like "nuff said," and I forget the others. I had a lot of expressions that I used. Little by little, I saw that they were appearing in the DC books. They were using a lot of my expressions. So I said to myself, see, I can say to myself, I didn't think to myself. I said to myself, I've got to think of an expression that they can't copy or won't copy because they're too dumb to know what it means. And I realized that the great seal of the state of New York has the word Excelsior on it, which is an old English thing that means upward and onward to greater glory. I kind of like that. So I decided to use the word Excelsior, and sure enough, nobody at DC yet has figured out what it means or how to spell it. Of course, if one of you tattles on me, well, you'll be in big trouble, I'll find out.
So DC could be Dull Comics or Duff Comics, right? Either way.
I like this, man. I like the way you think.
All right, next question here.
First of all, I just want to say thank you.
You're welcome, bro.
My mother
trained me to be polite.
Thank you for not only your contribution to the worlds of both comics and geeks who read them, but also for creating characters we can all relate to no matter what extraordinary circumstances they find themselves in. Growing up, I never really had many fictional characters I could look up to as role models. If it wasn't for the work you did at Marvel, characters like Spider-Man and the Hulk might not have resonated with me because of their determination to do the right thing, even when the rest of the universe didn't give a crap about what they were capable of accomplishing. So thanks for providing inspiration. And if I might have the audacity to request this, is it okay if I can meet up with you after the show is over so that I can involve you in a prank call with a couple of my friends? Please?
I think I have to go. I hurt myself being cool.
No, you know what Max said? Max said we should do it now. A prank call with his friends. Huh. Let's do it. Come on.
I have no idea what this is all about.
Okay. Most of my friends are actually living overseas, and they're probably fast asleep right now, so... However...
You're nervous, aren't you?
I'm nervous! I actually didn't think this would happen! Oh my goodness!
Wait, I heard him say all of my friends are, but I couldn't tell what came after that. All of your friends are what?
Okay. Okay.
They're asleep right now. That's good.
Oh, wow.
wow. Who said that? Oh, wow. He said it.
I am trying to find a guy.
Say what? Lee, take another question.
What's happening?
Okay. I can offer a compromise.
You're spending more time with him than with the panel guest.
I can record the message. They'll get the voice recording. Okay? Yes, I am.
You can't believe how much this kid is shaking right now. I mean, he's like a leaf in the wind.
And yeah, I'm just probably gonna get speared. Okay.
Well, let him come up here so I can know what's going on.
This is Stanley.
Hello, Jonathan. I think this is Stanley.
Also, I'm in a crowd of like 2,000. I'm facing a crowd of like 2,000 people. And make them live. So hopefully you can enjoy it.
How much is he paying for this?
Just wanted to record you a message of you.
He's gonna record you talking.
What if everybody in the audience wants to record something?
No, that's the last one.
Do you know what a dangerous precedent you've started?
All right, let's go to the next question. No recordings, okay?
You're a very strange group.
Stan, you are the man. And
I agree.
You're such a marvelous person. You've changed lives. But I was wondering, what character would you like to see on the bill? What character would you like to see on a film that has already not been put on a film? Like Moon Knight or Cloak and Dagger?
Oh, there are a few of them. I can't wait to see the Black Panther. I want to see Doctor Strange. The Unhumans, and we will see all of them as time goes by. Thank you.
All right, we're here on this side, please.
So I just have two quick things. My first thing is, of all the Marvel movies, who, like, which actor or actress do you think portrays their role the best?
Well, of all the actors in all the Marvel movies, I think that Robert Downey Jr. has made it so that nobody could play Tony Stark but him. He seems to be Tony Stark. And for those of you who aren't familiar, Tony, and don't let this get out, but Tony Stark is Iron Man.
What's your second part of your question?
My second part was, my younger brother's having his birthday in a few days, so I was wondering if you could just say happy birthday to him.
What's his name?
Jaden.
Hey!
Not Jason.
That nobody paid much attention to. So I went up there and I found out that the assistant was needed in the comic book department. I didn't expect to be in comics. I thought I'd be in one of the other magazines. And their whole department consisted of two guys named Joe Simon and Jack Kirby. So I was hired and I became their assistant. And I would run down and bring them sandwiches from the drugstore. I would erase the pages. I would fill the ink wells. In those days, we used ink. And I would do a little proofreading, and occasionally, if they needed something rewritten, they'd say, "Hey, Stan, can you rewrite this?" And I would do it. And I enjoyed it, and it was all right. And then, unexpectedly, Joe and Jack left. I never knew if they quit or were fired. Nobody ever told me what happened. But they quit working there. And I was the only guy left in the department. And I was about 17 and a half years old. And the publisher came in and said to me, "Hey, Stan, do you think you could look after things until we hire a grown-up?" When you're 17 and a half, what do you know? I said, "Sure, I can handle it." And I guess the comic books of those days were so unimportant that he never bothered hiring that grown-up. He left me alone. So little by little, I was the head writer, I was the art director, I was the editor. I hired other writers and artists, and I was running the place. And that's how it started, purely by accident. And years later, I hired Jack Kirby as a freelancer to draw for us, and the rest is history.
Great question. Thank you. Let's go to this side.
It was a great answer.
Great answer. Sorry. This side.
Hi, I got two questions. So, if you could have like a team up of two characters that haven't happened yet, who would they be?
That's a tough one. Are there any two that haven't teamed up yet? I'll answer it this way. Any two that you can think of that haven't yet teamed up, those are the two I would pick. I can't think of any.
That's a good answer. Okay. Second question.
Known for good answers.
Since you're in Edmonton and you're in Canada, have you had poutine yet?
No, I haven't.
Oh, Max says you're going to have poutine tonight.
I have it tonight? Is that a promise, Max? All right, now remember, you don't want to disappoint all these people. Okay.
Thank you. Is that it? Thank you, and I'd also like to say, Hail Hydra.
Oh, Hail Hydra. I wrote a whole thing about cut off the limb and others. There was a whole saying, I can't remember it now. Hydra was one of my favorite villain gangs. Hail Hydra, oh, which, does anybody remember the whole thing? You're a fine lot, you are. I bet at DC they'd know it. They read everything.
All right,
Hail Hydra, immortal Hydra. Cut off a limb and others will, I don't know, I can't, but I know the next words were immortal Hydra. And then it went on, and I was very proud of that. Because most people weren't writing little sayings like that for their villain. I mean, the Joker never had a Hail Joker, immortal Joker, in the whole written yet. It took Marvel to do that, but I digress.
Okay, let's take a question from this side, please.
Right, I gotta hurry here because we've been infiltrated by Hydra. Gotta watch out for them. Do you keep track of what's been going on in the comics lately, and what do you think of some of the stuff that's happened at Marvel?
Sorry?
I really don't keep up. I'm sorry to say this. I don't keep up as well as I should, because my eyesight has gotten so bad, I can't read the books, I can't read the small print, and I started having people tell me what the stories were, and that got too dull. So now I look at the covers, and I try to guess what's going on. So all I know is the girls look beautiful on the covers. Well, I sometimes think I'm reading Playboy. And I'm not objecting to that one bit. But as far as what's going on in the books, I don't know. I guess it's good. They're still selling, and I'm still doing my cameos, so everything is fine, except I have no idea what's happening anywhere.
All right, a question from this side, please.
Hi. If you were to choose a side in Captain America Civil War, what team would you choose?
Oh, whatever side Captain America was on, because he's the best, purest-hearted person in the whole world. By the way, he's a great actor, too. The guy who plays Captain America does a beautiful job. Yeah, Chris Evans.
Thank you.
I say that because he likes me, and anybody who likes me, I think, is a great actor.
Question from this side?
Okay, first off, I want to thank you so much for basically being my whole childhood and putting my dad and I together for the movies and stuff. And I want to know, since you've been to so many places, what was your favorite place?
You can talk. Edmonton! No, I'm very serious. I can't tell you how impressed I am with Edmonton. You people are great. The city is beautiful. It's clean. It's friendly. I love it here. I really do.
Thanks for that. Question on this side, please.
First, let me say it's an honor just to be in the same room as you, Mr. Lee.
Thank you.
And out of the Spider-Man movies, who do you think portrayed him better, Tobey Maguire or Andrew Garfield?
Tobey Maguire. I like Tobey. The other guy is good too. I'm partial to Tobey.
Thank you. This side, please.
What comic book was the most successful?
You know, I think it's a Spider-Man issue that had been done by, what's his name again? By McFarlane, the guy who did, Spawn. Tom McFarlane, is it Tom McFarlane? He's a good friend of mine. That shows you what happens to your memory when you get on in years. But, McFarlane wrote and drew a Spider-Man comic book some years ago, and I think it sold more than any comic book ever had before or since. So it would have to be Todd McFarlane.
Todd, yes. In the Guinness Book of World Records.
I said Tom, not you. I didn't mean to make you sound guilty. It was my fault. I don't know who you are over there, but still, I don't know.
Thank you. Over here, please.
So, how did you come up with Iron Man?
With what? How did you come up with Iron Man?
Well, sometimes you'd like a challenge. I realized at the time I started Iron Man, people were mostly hippies. They were against the war. They were against the army. They were against munitions makers. They even hated rich people. All the hippies wanted to do was change the world and make it good for the hippies, I don't know. So I thought, just for fun, I would come up with a character who is totally different, the kind of character the hippies would hate, and I'd make them like him. So I figured I'll get a guy who's a billionaire, who makes munitions, who loves parties and he loves the ladies, everything that the hippies sort of despise. And I did Tony Stark, and luckily it worked. So it proves if you're true to your convictions and you forge ahead. I'm getting too corny.
Okay. Over here, please.
After you die, what is going to happen to the Marvel industry?
Oh.
After I die, I'm not going to give a hoot. But seriously, nothing will happen. I'm not doing it. All I do is go to panels like this and conventions. I'm not doing the books anymore. They have a bunch of geniuses who are doing great books and great movies, and I will admit, we may miss my cameos, but aside from that...
Maybe they can have a holographic Stan Lee.
There
just
is
keeps
one.
Going.
They made a hologram of me. Wait till you see it.
Okay, over here.
Hi, Stan. My question for you is, what was the most fun comic book for you to write?
Snafu. I don't know if you remember it, but it was a book I did like Mad Magazine. I wrote it all myself, got all our artists to do little features, and it shows how everlasting humor is. None of you remember it. Anyway, that was the one I enjoyed the most.
Nice. Okay, over here.
Hi, I really love your work personally, and my question is, what inspires you to write about like the villains?
Well, I don't know that you need more inspiration to write about a villain than a hero, but you've got to get a villain who seems to have a reason for his villainy, whatever he's doing that's bad. He should have a motive that we can understand, and he should be powerful enough so that you figure, geez, how's the hero ever going to beat this guy? But speaking of villains, I want to mention something that you probably never thought of. Do any of you know the villain, Dr. Doom? I take that as yes. Well, I don't know if you've ever thought of this, but Dr. Doom really wants to rule the world. And he's considered one of our worst criminals. But if you think about it, there's no law against wanting to rule the world. If you want to rule the world, you could go up to a policeman and you could say, excuse me, officer, I'd like to rule the world. He can't arrest you. That's not a crime. Anybody could want to rule the world. So why do we consider Dr. Doom a villain? That man is not treated fairly, and it's time we did something about it. And that's all I have to say about that subject.
Thank you. Next question, please.
So I was wondering, I have two questions. Would you ever consider going back to DC to maybe do a crossover or helping out with like a Batman or Superman comic?
Are you familiar with the fact that a few years ago, I did a whole series of books for DC? I forget what they were called, something like What If Stan Lee Had Written, something like that. And I did Spider-Man, Superman, Batman, Green Lantern, Wonder Woman, I don't know, a few others. As if I was making them up, I didn't do them the way they were. And DC published them, and they sold like hotcakes. But there was nothing they could do with them, because if they started publishing a lot of them and making them famous, it would look bad for them, because they were characters that their rival had made up. And I never knew why they even asked me to do those books. It's one of the mysteries of comicdom that people will question and wonder about for decades to come.
I do remember that, and I remember it was Batman and Wolverine that got a lot together and then became Nightclaw. I believe, I correct me if I'm wrong, but my other question is that a while ago it was my birthday, and maybe after the panel, can we take a selfie as a LA birthday gift, maybe?
Wait, didn't you hear me say no more requests like that?
It's okay if not, that's fine. I could just like take a picture from far away or something.
You can take all the photos you want while we're answering the questions.
Are you like me standing in front of the stage or something?
If it's, it's okay if
not, no.
What? At the photo ops. Okay. That would be your best opportunity.
All right.
Thank you, though.
Yes, okay. Right. We have a photo op.
Over here.
Hi. I'm a little nervous because I realized I wore the wrong shirt today. But
hey, I'm pretty nervous sitting here.
I know. Also, I just wanted to say thank you for making Hero super. I don't know anyone else that can lay claim to that. And everyone else is asking two questions, so I'm going to ask two questions. First question, I'm actually an advertising copywriter, and I didn't know there'd be this many cameras, so I hope my boss doesn't see this, but what advice would you give an advertising copywriter who always dreamed of being a comic book writer?
Well, the same advice I give anybody. Try to find a script that you think you'd like to write, and do a sample story, and find a way to make your sample story as good or better than the guy who's writing the stories, and send it to the editor, and tell him you would like to write comics for that particular character. Would he be good enough to have somebody read your story and give you an opinion? And if it's really good, they might want to meet with you and give you something to do. If it's not very good, well, that wouldn't be you. Yours, I'm sure, would be good.
Thank you. Second quick question, and this is my nephew actually asked me to ask you specifically, if the Avengers and the Guardians of the Galaxy will ever team up in the movies?
Probably. Here's the point. The people at Marvel who do the movies are people who think just the way your nephew thinks. They
He's
say,
seven, by the way.
Pardon me?
He's seven.
Oh, well, they think the same way. And they're probably saying, what would the public like to see? And at some point, they're going to say, boy, if we teamed up the Guardians with whoever it was you mentioned, I forgot, that would make a great movie, and they will. They're always trying to think of something the public would like to see that would be a little unexpected.
Thank you very much, Stanley. It's been an amazing day.
Thank you. Okay, we're getting close to that time. We're going to take three more questions, and please just answer one per person, please. Yes.
Okay, just one question and no requests. I'm kind of curious, if you were scripting the ultimate Hulk versus Juggernaut fight, how would that go with the definitive winner?
Oh, I'd probably have the Hulk win because I like the Hulk. And the thing is, if you're a writer, you can have any character beat any character. You'd always find a way to do it.
Thanks so much, Dan. And
sure.
As a side, I just wanted to say that thank you again so much for being so compelling characters and storylines. From a personal perspective, it really helped me to learn English to kind of motivate me when I was a kid, but it wasn't my first language. So thank you so much.
Well, I'm delighted. Thank you.
Thank you.
Push it over here.
Send me money.
Hi, I'm kind of a fan of the manga Ultimo that you conceptualized, and I was just wondering how you took that concept and got it to Japan and shown it to Hiroyuki Takei and got them to make it.
How I got them to make Ultimo in Japan is actually they came to me a few years ago and asked if I had any idea for a character that they could do. And I came up with the idea of Ultimo, and I met with a Japanese artist, and we put the thing together, and I gave him the story, and he drew it. And ever since then, they've been writing the stories in Japan. I haven't been following up on it. I just started it with them, and I'm happy to say it seems to be doing very well now.
Very awesome.
Thank you. And over here, final question, please.
The new Ant-Man film was so successful.
It had a lot of humor in it, and I think people love humor, even in a serious story. It had visuals that you don't see all the time, and it had a superhero who nobody else would have dared make a superhero out of him. mean, when I proposed Ant-Man to my publisher, he thought I was crazy. Yeah, I want to get a character this big and call him Ant-Man. Get the hell out of here. But I finally talked him into it. I think he's just different enough. And the little bit of humor that was in the movie, I think that made it.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, thank you so much for coming to Stan Lee's panel.